So the chloroplast has inner membrane and outer. Okay, and then you will be able to see some coin-like structures. I think the portion for today's this week's test is protista and fungi. And next week's test will be full chapter biological classification. Yes, we are studying detailedly about chloroplast. I did not announce any test today, so I don't know. So this structure, it is filled with a fluid which is called as stroma. Okay, and then this entire part is called as the grana. And this in-between line is called as stroma lamellae. Okay, so this is how your chloroplast will look like. In the chloroplast, if you're going to see the single granum, granum is singular. You will be able to see that there are two layers like this. Okay, in that two layers in between, you will have the chlorophyll. Okay, so please understand, the pigment is present inside this thing. Okay, and this membrane together is called as the thylakoid membrane. And in between the center is called as the lumen. You have only one layer of that particular thing. Why I am trying to draw this way in two lines is because it is like kind of like in, I mean like the chlorophyll molecules are present in between, embedded on it, in the thylakoid membrane. Okay. So please understand, like let me explain, you'll be able to see this chloroplast. Chloroplast is a type of plastid. Okay. We have been studying about plastids. So chloroplast is a type of plastid. So if you're looking at that plastid, what is that you will be able to see is inside chloroplast, I mean it is covered by two membranes, outer membrane and inner membrane. What is it covering? It is covering a fluid which is called a stroma. It is a fluid filled space in which you are able to see some coin-like, stack-like structures. Okay, so this is the coin-like structure that you are able to see here. Okay, this coin-like structure is called as grana. Okay, and then these grana are interconnected by means of what we call it as stroma lamellae. Lamellae means a connection. The connection which is there in the stroma, so we call them as stroma lamellae. Okay. Out of this particular coin stack, if I'm going to see, take this only one layer, this is granum together. Grana is like plural. Plural of that coin stack, coin like stack. Okay. So in that coin like stack, if I'm just going to take that only one structure and then I'm going to see it, how will it look like? It will look like this. So this is the structure of a single granum. In the granum, you will see there is a center space which is called as lumen, which is covered by a membrane which is called as thylakoid membrane. And it is in the thylakoid membrane, in between only you will see the chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the pigment responsible for what? Pigment responsible for trapping sunlight. Okay, so this is the detailed structure of chloroplast. That single coin is called as, that single coin like structure is called as granum. In that granum, one single granum, it is covered by what? That disc like structure or coin like structure, it is covered by a thylakoid membrane and lumen. It will have thylakoid membrane and lumen. In between the thylakoid membrane, you will see what? Chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the pigment that is responsible for trapping sunlight. Kavipriya, are you clear? Thylakoid is the membrane which is there in the granum. The single structure is called as granum. You will study what is the use of lumen and all later. Okay, you will study in photosynthesis. The test portion for biology is protista and fungi. Whatever is pending from the last week's thing. Lakshan, Vijay, is this the first class that you are attending? Okay, listen, children, we'll write some notes quickly. So, start writing. Shape of chloroplast. Biconcave or spiral or cup shaped. This is in higher plants. This is in Spirogyra. And this is Chlamydomonas. Okay. And then the number of chromosome. Three between. to 40%. In leaves. Algae have one large chloroplast. Okay, so copy this thing down. Shape of the chloroplast, it can be biconcave or spiral or cup shaped. I have given you in which organisms examples. You can get a matrix match question like this. Match the following type. So they can give you biconcave. Example in one side, chloroplast shape. Okay, like that they can give you in match the following time. So please study this and all properly. I'm sorry, I made a mistake here. Number of chloroplasts. I was teaching chromosomes for the other batch, and all of a sudden I just shifted to this batch. No, human error. Are we clear? Can we move on? So the next one is structure. Chloroplast is covered by chloroplast envelope. It has two coverings. Thank you. usually we call it as stroma. Some people can call it as matrix also. The entire fluid filled space is called as stroma. There is a membrane system that consists of many flattened discs called as thylakoids. Ma, the membrane system is called as thylakoid. Okay. So that singular thing is one thylakoid covered by lumen is what we call it as granum. Okay. So please read here. There is a membrane system that consists of many flattened discs called as thylakoids. The disc-shaped structure is called as thylakoid. The thylakoid along with the lumen is part of that stack. That stack together is called as grana. The pile of thylakoids are together called as grana. Each grana has about 200 flattened thylakoids. this entire stack is called as the grana. This one disc is called as the thylakoid or granum. So basically, thylakoid membrane, whenever I'm using the word membrane, I'm talking only about the membrane. And in between space, I'm calling it as lumen. Okay. So you, some people call this granum as thylakoid also. You, each of this disc, no, each of this disc, we call it as thylakoid also. Okay. So like this, it is like kind of stacked. Okay, let me clarify. Okay, according to this particular thing, let us read this thing and then like let us try to understand. Okay, so please see here. Chloroplast is covered by an envelope. It has two layers, the outer membrane and the inner membrane. Okay, whatever that chloroplast is, the outer membrane, you are able to understand, this is the inner membrane. So here it is filling a space. The space is filled with the fluid. The fluid filled space, or that fluid, is called as stroma. Okay, so here this is the stroma. So here, and then next to this, there is a membrane system that consists of many flattened discs called as thylakoids. Okay, so each of this flattened disc, you are able to see this flattened disc. We call this as thylakoids. Okay, so this thylakoid will be, each thylakoid structure will be having what? The structure which is having a membrane, which is filled with the, some in-between space, which is called as the lumen. So this stack together, we call it as grana. And then it is connected by something called as a middle lamella or stroma lamella. Okay, and then this is again like what you call it as grana. This is the second grana. Like this, you are able to get the tracts. The tracts are called as grana. Am I clear? Okay. Granum is singular stack. Grana is plural stack. Is that clear? So various grana are joined together by thylakoids. Called as stroma lamellae. Okay, listen, I think I need to show you some diagrams because some people are lacking some clarifications. Okay, so see here, this is this diagram of this chloroplast. This is the outer membrane, this is the inner membrane. And then what you are able to see here is, you are able to see a lot of membranous structures that are there. All these things are membranous structures. Okay, you are able to see this flattened discs which are arranged. This flattened discs are the thylakoid. The thylakoid structure will have thylakoid membrane. Yeah, you can say this is a biconcave shape. So this is just that, like this is like a biconcave shape. What is the meaning of biconcave shape? Here we have seen biconcave means what? So here you are able to see this thylakoid membrane, thylakoid. Thylakoid is made up of thylakoid membrane, and inside the thylakoid you will have that lumen. Okay, and it is all stacked. This entire thing is a membranous system. Okay, when you're talking about this membranous system, this is what we call it as the, this is all like membrane based thing. So this is like this entire stack itself is membrane only. Just that it is kept as a stack. Are you guys able to understand? Okay, so Deekshita, please listen here. This is granum. When I am telling here, listen here, I have told you here, granum is singular stack. What is the meaning of stack? This one thing is called as a stack. A stack of coins means what? So this is a coin. 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 So this is called as a stack of coins. When we are talking about a singular stack, we call it as granum. When you call multiple, plural stack, many stacks together. So this is this along with this and along with this, if you are taking it all together, we call it as grana. Okay, singular stack means it is granum. Plural stack means it is grana. The membrane system is the center of light reaction. For photosynthesis. Okay, so if you want to understand what is light reaction, you will have to study photosynthesis. We'll study what is light reaction, dark reaction and all in photosynthesis, not as of now. Okay. The stroma is gel-like. And contains enzyme. The membrane system means I am talking about thylakoid. Okay, which contains enzymes that are involved in? Dark reactions. Okay, actually photosynthesis can be divided into two stages. One is what we call it as light reactions and the other one is what we call it as dark reactions. Okay, the light reactions will happen where in Keta, the light reactions will happen mostly in the thylakoid membrane system. Okay, whereas the dark reactions will happen in the stroma. So you will study about more in detail in your photosynthesis chapter. Okay, so as of now, you please just understand that there is something called as light reaction which is happening in the thylakoid system and there is something called as dark reaction which is happening in the stroma. Okay, so now we'll move on further functions. The first one is they are involved in photosynthesis. They contain the light harvesting complexes. They contain the enzymes required for photosynthesis. Okay, so these are all the functions. Please change it. You change this to granum, then you will understand it better. This is the meaning which I intended, okay? While I wrote, I kind of like wrote it as grana. Okay, you guys read it from the textbook, man. Okay, if you are done, we can move on further. We can move to ribosomes. They are small organelles. That are not membrane bound. No, we don't have to study about chromoplast and leucoplast because chloroplast is the only thing which is involved in photosynthesis, which is a very important function. So we will try to study only about chloroplast. We will not move to chromoplast or leucoplast. Just some basic information is sufficient. Okay, so ribosomes are the small organelles that are not membrane bound. They are scattered throughout the cells. The eukaryotic ribosome is of ATS type. It is made up of two subunits. The larger subunit, which is a 60S, and the smaller subunit, which is a 40S. Okay, so the size of this thing is usually it is 15 to 20 nanometer. Okay, are you done? So the next one is the structure. The larger subunit is dome shaped. It has a protuberance a ridge and a stalk. So you see here, okay, you can take this way. Protuberance is like kind of this kind of like curve that you are able to see here is called as a protuberance. Protuberance means inside an engravement, I mean like a kind of a niche which is created is called as a protuberance. This entire area is called as the ridge. Okay, an inward bend is called as a protuberance. This entire thing is called as a ridge, and this long extension is called as a stalk. So basically you are able to see three different structures here. It will has a protuberance. Protuberance is like kind of an inward movement. A ridge is that entire base, and stalk is that long thing that you are able to see here. Okay, so this is how your thing is made up of, larger subunit is made up of. We will not do chromoplast. The smaller subunit. It is ellipsoid basically. Or cap-like. Okay. Both the subunits together are seen only at time of protein synthesis. Okay, so basically you need to understand that these two things come together only at the time of protein synthesis. So it is like almost like a mixer jar and the mixie. Okay, so you have the mixie as a basic machine, and then like mixer jar is something separate. So when you want to function it, you are trying to bring them together, you are making it work, and then like again dismantling them. In the same way, the larger subunit and the smaller subunit will be like kind of dismantled whenever like it is not required. So whenever they are required, they will come assemble. Whenever they are not required, they are like kind of like removed altogether, and they will be like kind of dismantled. So the both the subunits will be coming together only when there is a protein synthesis which is happening. Okay. Ribosomes are made up of RNA molecules that are called as rRNA, ribosomal RNA. Okay, they also contain lipids and proteins. Okay, the proteins are called as ribonucleoproteins. Ribosomes attach to the endoplasmic reticulum when protein synthesis happens. The function of ribosome. Protein synthesis. It is a site of protein synthesis. Okay, you need to know that if there is this endoplasmic reticulum is there, what will happen is the larger subunit will come and attach, the smaller subunit will come and attach, but before that your mRNA will also come and attach, and then it will start to produce the protein. So let us say that the white color is the protein which is like kind of formed and it is trying to come out. This will come out and then like it will become the protein. Okay. So the ribosomes will attach to the endoplasmic reticulum when protein synthesis happens. So this is how it is there. This is the larger subunit. This is the smaller subunit. It is attached with the mRNA. And it will try to produce the protein. So this is the protein that is produced. So that is how it is there. The RNA which is making the ribosomes is called as rRNA or ribosomal RNA. Okay. This is an mRNA. This is a messenger RNA. We'll study about the type of RNAs in the next chapter, biomolecules. Okay, so with this thing, ribosomes is also over. So we have completed chloroplasts, plastids, and we have also completed ribosomes. So now we can move on to all the slides. When we say synthesis of proteins, they link amino acids or produce amino acids itself. Amino acids are not produced by bodies. Okay. Amino acids are produced only by plants. Okay. And there are certain amino acids produced by human beings in the body. But the amino acid production will not happen in ribosomes. It is only they are giving that link between amino acids. So whenever you are talking about amino acids, they will be like linked together by a peptide bond in the ribosome. So this is the amino acid. This is the peptide bond which is being created. So this happens, this peptide bond formation happens in ribosomes. So only plants will have the ability to synthesize amino acids. And in human beings, there are certain amino acids which are called as non-essential amino acids. Those are like converted from one form to another form, it is created. Okay, first slide. Second slide. That's right. Yeah, ribosomes do not produce amino acids. Ribosomes' role is just to join amino acids. Fourth slide. Fifth slide. Sixth slide. Seventh slide. Eighth slide. First slide. Fifth slide. Sixth slide. Seventh slide. Second.